Hi everyone, this video will be the first of three. We saved this laundry room pretty much for last because everything works in here, but as for the aesthetics and functionality, we have to really think this one through to get the most out of this little space. As you can see, I start off by cleaning up the space that I'll be working on, taking off outlet covers and disconnecting water supply lines, and making sure to drain any water left in the hot and cold water hoses because there's always some left in there. Here I carefully remove the water supply cover. It snaps in and out, and because it's not the strongest kind of plastic, I had to be careful not to break it. I aligned this piece of wood to be at the same level as the top of my sink. Once it was perfectly level, I screwed it into the wall. I did this to support the tiles that will be on that side. I have a laser and I like to use it to make sure that my first row of tiles is as straight and level as possible. Making sure this first row is done right makes all the difference. Wet tile saws are great, but I recommend getting a stand so you can save your back from any unnecessary bending. Now that we've started laying the tiles, as you can see here, we're back buttering the tile for better adhesion. It's not a heavy tile. And so for some, they might skip the back buttering, but we like to make sure it's there to last. We chose a green toned tile, which funny enough, seems to be becoming a theme in our house. We seem to have a lot of green and wood tones, which do actually complement each other pretty well. Our tile placement here is a bricklay pattern, which is one of the many tile placement options out there for you. We waited 24 hours, then grouted all the spaces. We didn't use spacers because we wanted the thinnest grout line possible. Just in case anyone was wondering, if you don't use spacers, you still end up with a little gap. So if you're looking for the tiniest grout line, this is probably the way to do it. This part is just a lot of wiping to make sure I leave as little grout residue on the tiles as possible. I made the mistake a few times before thinking I wiped it really well, only to find out the next day it had hardened on the tile. It was a real pain to clean that off. Speaking of cleaning, I got some tape stuck on the edges of the sink. I put it there to kind of protect the sink from any of the mortar getting stuck on there, but a little bit got stuck. So I scraped it off, and then I was just vacuuming everything, getting rid of the dust residue that was left behind, and some of the mortar and dust that fell on the ground. Now that I vacuumed away all the dust, I then wet wiped everything down, because around the sink, I will be siliconing it just to make sure that it is waterproofed. As I wait for the edges of the sink to dry, I decide to use that time to reinstall the electrical cover plates and reattach the plumbing lines and put back the cover that goes over the plumbing supply unit. Take me off to the place where one reviews life's mystery. Steady on down the line, lose every sense of time. Take it all in and wake up that small part of me. Day to day I'm blind to see and find how far to go. Everybody got their reason, everybody got their way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. It gets into your body. Now that the top of the sink is dry, I silicone the edges carefully, and then I wipe away any excess silicone to make sure that it's a nice, clean line. And there you have it, we completed part one of our laundry room renovation. And I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you stay tuned for our second part, which will be building custom cabinetry for unique spaces.